The government says floods and landslides due to Lando have rendered 36 roads and 8 bridges unpassable. For more on the damage to infrastructure, we have on the line live Public Works and Highway Secretary Rogelio Singson. Good evening, Secretary Babes. Good to have you with us. I know you've really been busy over the last 48 hours. You've been scouring the north of Luzon since Monday. What is your assessment on the damages of Lando?
Well, we were expecting probably worse than what we saw. The damage really is just not too much in terms of cost so far, you know? But it just takes a little bit more time to clear the roads out of landslides and flooding and debris. But otherwise, so far, we've not received any report on major bridges being knocked down or broken.
Secretary, you say that the clearing operations have been a little bit more difficult than expected, but it is indeed critical in the next few hours and days to get relief and later on the rebuild of some of the damaged infrastructure. What is causing that difficulty?
Kathy, we really focus on making sure that the relief goods would be able to reach Baler and Aurora province. So we were able to do that yesterday. And this afternoon, we were able to already open the Dalton Pass to Vizcaya, because our fear is if we're not be able to open, then relief will have to be airlifted. But as of today, we've been able to open the roads to Vizcaya and to Aurora province.
In places like Baler, Aurora, correct me if I'm wrong, Secretary Babes, but every time a typhoon strikes like this, it is a town that gets pretty much isolated because the infrastructure, the roads, the bridges really haven't been improved in that section. What has been done to improve or at least refurbish or upgrade the roads and bridges to ensure that we do not get disconnected with them when this happens?
We're actually in the process of paving the whole stretch from Baler to Kasiguran. We're not done yet, so we will have to do the roads and then do better slope protection in those areas. In the case of Dalton Pass, this has always been problematic because Dalton Pass is the link other than the going around Ilocos Norte is the only link to Region 2. So we are in the process of doing an alternate route to Dalton Pass. So that's ongoing. I don't think we should rely on a single Dalton Pass going to Region 2.
Indeed. And I was just speaking with the agriculture ASEC, Adelberto Luna. He did tell me that most of the crop damage had come from Region 3. In your own assessment, the infrastructure damage, would you say is solely in Region 3? Are you also seeing some in Regions 1 and 2?
The damage is the unpassable roads in Region 3 were caused either by mudslides or flooding. So the flooding, once it recedes, then the roads will just need some cleaning up and they can be usable. The more difficult ones would be in the Cordilleras because, you know, the roads there are on very steep areas and they're very vulnerable to landslides and rock slides. That is a little bit more problematic than just the flooding problem.
Are we getting any help from foreign agencies, or are you comfortable and confident that the DPWH, the government themselves, can work on the clearing operations when Lando exits the Philippines?
At this time, we can do it ourselves. We have the resources of the private contractors available to us. In addition to that, in the last several years, we've been upgrading our own pool of equipment, and we made sure that it is these far-flung areas where we first deployed the newly purchased reliable equipment.
Okay, well, thank you so much for joining us, and good to have you back here in Metro Manila. I understand you'd already been back in the city. Thank you, sir.
And yes, that was
Babes
so
Singson of DPWH on the line, live with us here on Business Nightly.